Now we'll see improve your learning question answers of animal fiber, that is silk and wool. We'll see the first question. In sericulture industry, do which stages of silkworm do weavers buy? Why do they do so? So which of the stage of silkworm are bought by the weavers? We'll see. In sericulture industry, weavers buy silk yarn from reeling centers to weave a variety of saris. They buy silk yarn after reeling stage. The silk yarn they buy is ready to be woven into variety of designed fabrics. In each stage, many machines, that is power looms and manpower hand looms, are involved. Weavers are trained to weave fabric from silk yarn. They cannot do the previous work, that is before the silk yarn, the steps before the silk yarn, they cannot do that. So to obtain threads from cocoon, that is next. Hence they buy silk yarn to weave fabrics. Next, we move on to the second question. Which place in our state is called Silk City? So Pochampalli is called as the Silk City of Telangana. Next, third question. Prepare a chart showing life cycle of silkworm and display. So here are the different steps of the silkworm. So first one is egg. Then the eggs develop into different larval forms. These are the larval forms. And from larva, it changes into pupa, imago, and an adult will be form. These are the stages of the silkworm. Egg, larva, pupa, and adult moth are the stages in the life cycle of silkworm. Next, fourth question. Why are cocoons stifled? The larva of silkworm undergoes changes in the cocoon to change into a moth. After 2 to 3 weeks, young moths come out of from the cocoons and fly away. Within 2 to 3 days of formation of cocoon, we start removing them from the tray. We kill the larva inside by process called stifling. By putting a lot of these in a steam oven for 10 to 15 minutes. Then the cocoons have to be stifled to kill the larva inside. Otherwise, it will cut its way out after growing into a moth and spoil the cocoon. We will not be able to get a continuous thread of silk from such a cocoon. Thus, we won't be able to obtain quality fiber for fabrics. Hence, the cocoons have to be stifled. Next question. What will happen if cocoon is not boiled? Boiling is nothing but stifling simply. Stifling helps in storing the cocoons for a long time. But if the cocoon is not boiled, the larva inside the cocoon cuts its way out after growing into a moth and spoil the cocoon. We will not be able to get a continuous thread of silk from such a cocoon. Hence, they have to be boiled. Cocoons have to be boiled. Next, sixth question. What are the differences between fleece of Angora goat and camel? The fleece of Angora goat and camel are different. As a fleece of camel have rough and coarse hair, and that of Angora goat have soft hair. Next, we move on to the next question. Seventh one. Make a flow chart showing various stages of production of woolen fabric. So these are the different stages for the production of woolen fabric. First one is shearing, scouring, sorting, bleaching, dyeing, combing or carding, spinning, weaving, knitting, rolling or twisting. Then lastly, we are going to obtain the woolen fabric. This already I have explained the processes in our lesson animal fiber. You can refer to it for the definitions. So these are the stages for getting the woolen fabric. Next question, 8th one. In what way is knitting different from weaving? Knitting is done with hands in which there are only knots with loops and rings of woolen yarn. In weaving, the threads are stretched from the top of loom to the bottom. These are called wrap threads. The threads that go side to side are weft threads. These threads are weaved on hand looms or power looms. So two types of threads are from top to bottom. These are called wrap threads, and from side to side, these are called weft threads. Next, 10th one, dash fabric protect us from cold. So here woolen fabric protects us from cold. Next, 11th question, if you are going to visit Dal Lake at Kashmir, which type of cloths would you like to keep in your luggage? Why? So here Kashmir is a cold place in our country. If we are going to the visit Dal Lake at Kashmir, we have to carry sweaters, mufflers, gloves, socks and woolen blanket along with us to protect ourselves from cold, because it is a cool place. Next question, 12th one. Do you find any similarities between silk and wool weaving? What are they? See, the procedure for production of silk yarn and wool yarn may be different, but the process of weaving silk fabric or wool fabric is same. Both type of threads are arranged as wrap and weft threads. Next, write 5 differences between wool and silk manufacturing. Here, silk, wool. Silk is obtained from silkworms and wool is obtained from sheep, goat, camel, yak. Silk thread is the saliva of a silkworm, which contains 2 proteins, sericin and fibroin. Here wool is the fur collected from animals which contains a protein called keratin. Next, silk is obtained from cocoons of silkworms. Wool is obtained from hair of animals. Silkworms are reared in special frames. Sheep, camel are reared in farms. The larva and the cocoons are killed and thread is reeled. Without any harm to animals, fur is collected, washed and bleached to make wool yarn. So this is the last question, and 2 more questions are activity based questions. You have to write on your own.